Today I'm gonna play Cyberpunk 2077 the Phantom Liberty DLC and I want to show how can get these amazing Mantis Blades. These are legendary items and I'm not sure if there is another way of how can get them, but definitely you can get them in the expansion only by completing certain things and by doing certain choice in the last mission. This game is gonna have some spoilers, so beware of that. But I'm not sure how big they're gonna be, but you cannot get weapons without any spoilers in this game, in my opinion, at least the best ones. Now, in the first part of this video, in the first small part of this video, I'm gonna show you how this thing works, how good it is, and we're gonna enjoy a little bit these Mantis Blades on the street. I really like to play with this thing. It's fun, and it's a special tech. It has a special technology that you can get only by, as I just told you, only by doing certain choices. If I'm not wrong, also you can get this max tech Mantis Blades, because yes, these are the max tech Mantis Blades. You can get them from a from a psycho killer or something like that in the first part of the game, but if you already did that, it will be hard to get them now. But if you have the Phantom Liberty DLC, it's quite easy to get those. I don't have the best build for this type of things. Definitely you can get an insane build with that you're gonna kill with one hit every single one of your enemies, at least the regular ones, and trust me, you can make a really really good build. But I'm an average player when I test my weapons, that because I'm guessing that most of my viewers will be average players like me and they just want to see how this thing works. Now, as I just told you, you have to do certain choices, and let's start. The first thing, when you have to do the first choice, it will be during the mission Firestarter. You cannot miss the Firestarter mission if you are taking the main path of the missions, but here you have to do certain choices. Only and only if you choose to side with Reed, you basically you're gonna have two options. If you don't know that, this is the first spoiler. You'll have the option to side with Songbird, and also you have the option to side with Reed. There are multiple outcomes if you do that, but if you want to take this this max tech Mantis Blade, you have to side with Reed when you're gonna have this this question right here. And if you decide to do that, we can just move on. The next mission after you're gonna complete the Firestarter, and also after you just sided with Reed, it's gonna be Black Steel in an Hour of Chaos, and now it will be the next choice. When you're gonna call Mr. Hand, you have to accept the offer for the Netrunner, and you have to pay him 15k. That is the way to do it. So pay him that 50k, and now let's move on. The next step, you're gonna go to meet a Netrunner, and also here you're gonna accept, because he's gonna give an offer. Take the shard, and maybe take the first choice, because you're gonna have two different choices. Take the first one in order to get some other items from that mission. Okay, next step. Here, during the same mission, after you're gonna talk on this balcony at this abandoned hotel, after you're gonna talk with Reed, you're gonna have the option to text a message to Mr. Hands. Don't forget to do that, it's very important, because I think this is when you trigger the present, that present to be in your house. So, if you have the option, you will have the option to text the message with the coordinates to Mr. Hands. Just do that. And after you're gonna complete the main mission, don't matter what is your outcome, if you decide after at the end of this campaign, if you decide to kill Songbird or to save her, you're gonna get a phone call like I just did here, and also with a message. And in that message, it's gonna tell you to read that message, and in that message, it's gonna tell you just to go in your apartment, and he just left you something there, Mr. Hands. Now, we're gonna go to the apartment. If you not find something in that chest, for some of the players it's bugged, all you have to do is to load and save. Save and load. Try that method. So, this will be the Max Tech Mantis Blades. This is the gift from Mr. Hands to you, and it's a pretty awesome one. Just take it. It's a legendary tier 5 plus item. I'm gonna upgrade it just to show you, and also I'm gonna show how you can put it on, but most of the player will know by now. All you have to do is to go to a Reaper Doc Medic, And right here we have to put here on your arms. I already had a mantis blade on me, but I'm gonna put these babies, this beautiful thing. And also I'm gonna upgrade it to see what are my choices. Depends what is your build, you have three different options to upgrade this thing. These are all the three options to make it way much better. It's gonna cost you 32k and some 200, oh my god, how much 200 legendary items. But lucky for you, I have the perfect method of how can get a limited legendary components. The video is already on my channel. And then all you have to do is to equip it and just start to have a lot of fun. Like always, you can hit the like button, subscribe, share, press the notification bell. I'm gonna see you really soon in the next one with more and more awesome items. Love you all. Bye.